The crop rotation, I kind of get a kick out of because everybody wants to know what your crop rotation is. Well, best made plans are just plans. It seems like every year our crop rotation changes, or maybe the weather's different. And you have to be very, very flexible and open with a quote rotation, because it seems off more often than not, it's very hard to stick to a set plan.
For organic field crop farmers, weed control starts with crop rotation. In this video, farmers share their strategies for rotating crops to interrupt weed cycles and suppress weed growth and reproduction through planting solid-seeded perennial crops like alfalfa, to incorporating cool-season spring-seeded small grains like oats, to fall-seeded small grains like winter wheat, rye, or triticale.
There's probably as many different ways that organic farmers look at this as there are organic farmers, but it kind of all begins with the crop rotation, and it depends on a lot of things, you know, what you have for equipment, what you have for markets. You know, my go-to rotation is basically corn, soybeans, and small grain, and I have a cover crop, usually red clover, in with the small grain so I can get raise some of my own nitrogen for the following corn crop.
Usually when I'm thinking about the rotation, I like to throw in that third year of oats or small grains. Mainly to kind of break up weed cycles.
In a goal on our good soil, best laying fields, we really like Dick Thompson's original rotation of corn, soybeans, corn, oats, hay, and that seems to work really well for both one, income, and two, weed control.
I do like corn, soybeans, corn, and then it'll go to oats with an underseeding of like an organic plow down mix of clover and alfalfa.
While many organic farmers plant corn after alfalfa or clover, Nelson Smith of Brighton typically follows alfalfa with soybeans. At his 2018 field day, Nelson said that he thinks the nitrogen credit is best achieved 2 years after killing the green manure crop, which has been supported by a growing body of research. Also, he likes planting soybeans after alfalfa because the year after alfalfa is typically the year with the lowest weed pressure, and soybeans are more prone to weed pressure than corn due to later canopy closure.
We'll start out with oats and alfalfa, and then after the alfalfa, depending on how good the alfalfa crop is, we may keep it 2 or 3 years for hay production, but we'll go to soybeans then after the alfalfa, and then corn following that. And then on a basic rotation, we'll go back to the oats with the alfalfa underseeding on it.
Typically, it's always been corn beans, then a small grain, and into hay for a year. And then after a year of hay, it gets plowed up and back into that corn bean rotation. That's typically been the norm anyway. Some time of years, it might be a little bit different. I might do a corn small grains rotation depending on weed pressure and in fields and how they work out.
A lot of people think that you should put your corn in right after the alfalfa so you get the nitrogen, but the problem is we don't tear up the alfalfa until very late in the fall, or we even wait till spring and disc it in. Because we've been organic for so many years, the ground is very mellow, so we can actually go out and tear up the alfalfa with a disc in the spring and still plant. And the soybeans go in the alfalfa because that's the cleanest year, is the first year after the alfalfa, so it's much easier to get weed control. So then we go with the soybeans right after the alfalfa, and then follow that with the corn, because the corn makes a good canopy for itself because of the height of the corn and the shading. So we follow that then behind the soybeans as our rotation.
The solid seeded crops are typically grown typically cool season crops, and therefore you're harvesting midsummer, and before the bulk of your weeds go to seed, you can either clip them, mow them off, or till them under. And easier ways, different ways to control it to break up that cycle of just plant in April, May, harvest in October, November. If you repeat that kind of 6 month cycle year after year, nature just selects weeds that grow in that same cycle. Or if you can break up that cycle and say plant a crop in March or April, harvest it in July, there you've just interrupted that weed's natural life cycle and gives you an opportune time to go in, mow it off before it goes to seed, till it under, et cetera. Or with alfalfa or hay, you're mowing it 3-4 times a year, constantly clipping that weed off before it gets a chance to grow seeds or grow root reserves to spread, et cetera.
I do have some alfalfa periodically, mainly to help me control Canada thistle that I really can't control any other way very well. So, but alfalfa for a good stand of alfalfa for 3 years does a pretty good job. Maybe doesn't eliminate them, but it really cuts them back.
Well, you can't go like a conventional crop is corn and soybeans, and basically that's not really a rotation. It's just a changing of the crop. But with the alfalfa in there, that gives you the year that you had the oats and the nurse crop for the alfalfa, and then the alfalfa will hold your seed down or your weed seed down because you're clipping it to make hay, hopefully 3 times a year to get your 3 cuttings on it. And then when you disc that in and put your next crop in, you've held the weeds back and they're much easier to handle.
The one thing that I do with my rotation is my small grain hopefully is a winter annual, like fall triticale, for example. And if you can put a winter annual in your rotation, that will help mess up the cycle of the summer annual weeds and help you with your weed control. Whereas if you had all summer annual row crops, for example, like just a corn bean rotation, particular weeds are going to be particularly adapted to that system. And whatever your system is, there will be weeds that find that system advantageous. And so you need to be willing to change things up occasionally too. If you have a particular weed that's gaining ground, becoming, more populous, you need to do something to mess up its growth cycle somehow, mechanically, culturally, genetically, something.
We've started growing some winter wheat as well on some of our weedier fields. And what we've found is that gives you that time that you can till the field in the late summer, break up that weed cycle, and that crop then has a head start for the next spring. It's growing then in March and April and can out jump the weeds and out compete the weeds hopefully. And then you're harvesting that winter annual then in June, early July, which is again off normal timing. And then you can go back in and mow those weeds and it just breaks up that weed cycle.
If we need rye for a cover crop, we'll seed the rye with an airplane in the standing corn. And then we get our harvest our corn, and then we've got our rye underneath that that'll come on the next year. When the rye is harvested in the middle of the next summer, then a lot of times we'll put our buckwheat in to finish out that, because the buckwheat is a really short season, 75-day growing season on that, and then we can harvest that at the killing frost, because you need to get it out. Then once it's dead, it doesn't last through a killing frost. So.
And what we've started doing as well is growing 2 cool season crops in a row followed by 2 warm season crops. So we're growing oats followed by winter wheat, followed by corn, followed by soybeans. Then in 2 years, you get more time to break that cycle. So you're breaking that cycle then 2 years in a row to kind of outcompete or break that routine of the weeds, where if you just do 1 year, you'll reduce some of them, but there's still some that survive. And then the next year they'll come back. Or if you do it 2 years in a row, or leave alfalfa 2 years in a row or more, you're breaking that cycle longer, which can really help weed pressure. And we've seen some really drastic declines in weed pressure by going with a little bit longer rotation and doing more solid seeded crops and winter crops versus just the typical corn, bean, oat rotation or whatnot.
longer rotation, the longer rotation you get, the better off you can control your weeds, because the weeds don't have a chance to come on, put on a seed bed on there, and then come the next year, you've changed it to a different crop. So they're changing and you're changing, trying to stay ahead of them.
Yeah, if we can get to like a 3 or a 4 or even a 5 or 6 year rotation, that changes when we're harvesting and when we're cutting weeds. And so if we can, if like we do a soybean year, generally we're just doing inner row cultivation and killing weeds at a certain young point. Whereas with the oats, if we can cut them before our weeds go to seed, that'll kind of break up their reproduction and keeping those weeds from setting a seed.
The more consecutive years of row crops you get, the harder weed control gets immensely. If you break up that row crop year with a year or two of solid seeded crops, you can drastically see your weed pressure reduced.